We all know what you eat can help you stay healthy, but did you know there are certain foods that can actually help fight cancer? Beth Bennett, dietitian from The Gathering Place, is with us now. She's going to show us how to make a colorful quinoa salad. Beth, good morning.
Hi, Wayne. Thanks so much for having me.
Thanks for stopping by. First of all, real briefly, you guys are doing amazing things at The Gathering Place.
Thank you. I think so, too.
Yes, yes.
I think so, too.
Now, you've been there 5 years.
I've been there 5 years.
You're the dietitian.
I'm the dietitian. I'm also a physical therapist, so I also help people with movement as well as nutrition at The Gathering Place.
For those who don't know, real briefly, what does The Gathering Place do?
Well, The Gathering Place, we're a community-based cancer support center, an integrative center, and we help people physically, emotionally, spiritually with the side effects of cancer and the cancer journey. So we work with people who have cancer as well as people who are caregivers.
The goal is quality of life.
Exactly, quality of life, maximizing quality of life.
All right, Joe, you have some beautiful, beautiful stuff right here. You know,
thanks.
I'm a big veggie guy myself, but you have vegetables that are good for people who are fighting cancer and also if you want to prevent cancer. Talk about
exactly.
That.
So what I have here, oftentimes when somebody hears they have cancer, they think, oh, is it something I ate or didn't eat? And they want to clean up their diet. Well, there isn't a food that causes or cures cancer, but inside every one of the foods I have here are some amazing cancer-fighting benefits.
Talk about some of the stuff that you brought with you today.
Okay, so right here I brought broccoli. This is the cruciferous family, and they're doing a lot of research in this with this particular type of vegetable.
Okay.
I brought squash, beta-carotene, great antioxidants. Apples have lots of antioxidants. Anything with color, you know, they tell us eat foods that have, you know,
from
put
the
color.
Rainbow, the rainbow.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
Walnuts as well, and lots of different leafy greens.
Leafy greens.
So a lot of times people are like, well, what do I do with all this stuff, and how do I make it taste good for not just me, but also for my family? So this salad is a real big hit at The Gathering Place.
I mean, everything you see there is going
is
to be,
going
in,
to be
salad.
In here. And actually what we do at The Gathering Place, we have hands-on cooking classes. So it's not about me cooking like this for
them. It's people doing it themselves.
Them doing it for themselves.
That's good
exactly.
Stuff.
So they would come in and they would work together in a small group and prepare something like
this. This is a quinoa salad.
Yeah, so this is a protein. So if we're trying to eat a little less meat and processed foods, we still have to have good protein.
And that's
what the quinoa is. So we're going to put, this is already cooked up.
Okay.
And I'm going to start with my vegetables.
Okay. Now, real quickly, how do you cook that for those who don't
know? It's a 2-to-1 ratio, just like rice.
Okay.
So you're going to use 2 parts liquid. I use vegetable broth. And the nice thing about quinoa is it's high in protein, high in fiber. It's actually a complete protein.
Okay.
And it's got lots of good vitamins and minerals. So it's
good
a real
stuff.
Powerhouse.
It's like a superfood.
It's a superfood, indeed.
All right, let's do it.
And just quickly, if this is too expensive, sometimes cost can be an issue, you can easily substitute your protein with lentils or beans.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So, okay. So this is done, and what we want to do is we want to start with some greens.
Okay.
Now, this is kale. There's lots of different types of kale.
Everybody likes kale.
Everybody likes kale. It's good for us, but it can be a little bitter, so I cut it real fine.
Okay.
And then you can add any kind of color. So we'll put a few carrots in here, that nice beta carotene. And here's our other superfood with
broccoli.
Mm-hmm.
All good stuff.
All good stuff.
Yep.
And then let's put some peppers in. Again, sweet peppers. You can do, and again, open your refrigerator and whatever veggies you have,
just
throw
it
in. I'm going to add another little protein to this. This is just a soybean, but you could easily add any type of bean. And then let's start with a little dressing. Now, a lot of times when people are dealing with cancer, they're trying to cut back on all the fat.
Okay.
And so this is a nice, light dressing that's just the 5 ingredients, olive oil, lemon, garlic, sea salt.
And you put that
and
together
honey.
Yourself.
Okay. I did. I put that together earlier.
Okay.
So we'll just spoon a little bit of this in.
Okay.
I'm just going to stir that up a little bit.
Okay, I'll stir it up.
Yeah, so what we want to do first is just get our little dressing in there, stir that around, and we'll let that marinate.
All right. Now, Beth, we have about 30 seconds. Is that enough time to get this together?
Okay. That's all done. So all we do with that, we add our quinoa.
Nice.
We'll stir that around.
Okay, stir that together.
I'm a big fan of having our participants taste the food as they go along.
You get it. That's okay. That's what we do here.
And just for ease today, we'll just keep it simple.
And what's that?
This is just parsley. We have a nice herb garden at The Gathering Place.
It is a beautiful place, too. Very, very serene, very nice.
And then
very nice place there.
We'll mix that in.
So the key is you don't cook for them. Teach them how to cook.
They would cook this in a cooking class, exactly. And then when you're ready, we'll just
Can I, okay.
put that up.
Christy Capel, do you want some of this? Christy Capel's a big quinoa fan. Okay, I'll plate her one up, and myself. Oh well, since she's not here yet.
Okay.
No, I'll plate hers. And is there Stephanie around anywhere?
Show us your plate.
Okay, I'll show the plate in a second. Boy, this looks good. Beth, this really looks good. All right, this is what it looks like.
So notice all the good
color.
Can you
get us all that?
Yeah.
That's nice.
Mmm.
That is so nice. Very, very nice.
Quinoa is so easy to make, too.
It's easy to make?
Mm-hmm.
I've never made it.
It's very easy to make.
Beth, thank you.
Thank you,
for stopping
Wayne.
By.
Thanks
good information.
So much.
Good information. Well, the recipe on our website, fox8.com. Just click on the Morning Show tab. We'll be right back, Steve.